just sitting here on my porch having coffee with all of you. But last night we had a heck of a storm. Woo, this is getting crazy out here. Oh my gosh. Oh my lord. Look at those trees over there. Oh, shoot. Whoa, I'll be surprised if I got any trees. Oh my goodness. That's not too terribly bad. Oh my lord. I bet you everybody's power is out. Let me go see what Mr. Lucas is up to. I think I just saw him walking around with his light. Yep, he's got his flashlight on, so I'm pretty sure that the electricity is out. I figure it's probably a good time to go take a look around the property. I got my jammies on with my boots. Can you see? Got a little bit of water in this bucket. Chicken coop made it through the night. And the tarp did come off, so yeah, I'll have to secure that. That's not a big deal. Rocket stove stayed intact. Well, looks like either something tried to blow off this lid that is totally ready, or let's just put this upside down and let it drain. There we go. Okay, even though that it rained like absolute craziness, this still stayed up, so that's pretty awesome. Let's see how much water I got. I already know that barrel is full. Oh, look, it all came up. Look at the little clips. They're all down there. And, gosh, I'm surprised it's not full. I'd say it's about half full. Yeah, about half full. That's okay. I'll come back and fix this later. Yeah, the wind was absolutely crazy. So, yeah, all I've got is a few little limbs down here and there. Really nothing too earth-shaking. Doesn't look like I lost any big trees. All the ones that are leaning or are down were already down. Let's go take a look at the stream. The stream is kind of like a weird thing now. It has dried up completely even after I've had a few days of rain. So, well, it looks like I've got a little bit of water down there, but not nearly as much as I would have had before. Look at that, hardly any water. So, you know what this makes me think? Because this really is just water runoff. I don't think it's like a river or anything. I mean, I call it a creek, a stream, whatever. But I think what it is it is basically just drainage. 200 is off in the distance a little bit over there, and I know that right before 200 there's a big culvert over there, so maybe they fixed the culvert over on the other side way off in the distance, and that's why I'm not getting as much water over here, which is kind of disappointing because I kind of liked having this stream here. But you know what, that's all right, that's okay. I'm still capturing water. Oh yeah, we got some big tree limbs down right over there. Not a big deal, that's okay. I can take that over to the garden beds and put them in there. It just saves me having to go looking around for them. So that kind of makes me a little bit happy. If you came down over here, over my dill bed, that's okay, I'll put it off later. Oh, I didn't tell you, but Mr. Lucas onions, I planted them down in this little spot, and they are starting to grow a little bit, so that makes me very happy. Ooh, look at a big tree limb came down here. So, yeah. Yeah, it's so funny because when the wind starts coming up, I'm always hearing something cracking and falling off in the distance here. Just so long as it's far away from the tiny house, that's just fine with me. So yeah, there's one there. This is all great for me though, because I can put it in these raised beds down here. And let's just see what it looks like down here by my little raised beds. Good thing is this cardboard is totally soaked, so it's totally time for me to put some leaves on top and then put the soil down. So that's great. Yeah, I think just a few more sticks here and there, not very much. I've got some actually kind of some big ones. I might take those out and, burn them and put smaller ones in. But look at all of this. Watermelons in front, Brussels sprouts, butternut squash. I may see if Mr. Lucas wants some of those. Spaghetti squash, Brussels sprouts, and zucchini. So these are all really coming up so good. And yep, this garden bed's doing good too. It's all very soaked, which is what I want. So that makes me happy. Thank goodness my pretty flowers made it. And check this one out. Look at those little things off to the side. Those are new. Those are totally new. So when Mr. Lucas said these spread, he wasn't lying. So yeah, the rest of these are looking okay. Question, these little ones with the brown on them, the leaves, should I cut them off? Or should I just let them go? Let's look at the other ones on the other side. All right, so this one that I thought was dead is still living. That's good. And this one's doing just fine too. So I think that they are all gonna be just fine. And take a look at these guys. I didn't grow them, Mr. Lucas did, but when I was over there talking to him yesterday, he said, "You want some flowers?" And he just took out his little pocket knife and cut me off a bunch of flowers, and they're just so pretty. I keep them inside the tiny house, but this morning I wanted to just sit them out here with me so I could look at them while I'm having my coffee. But, oh, my back. See, it's got little buds that they'll open eventually, and I was afraid I didn't have anything to put them in, but I've got all these lovely mason jars, so look at that. That really brightens my day, and they smell so good. Yeah, I'm feeling pretty blessed this morning. This day is starting out really super great. As I was getting ready to go in and get dressed, FedEx pulled up and dropped me off 2 packages. I've had a couple subscribers tell me that they were sending me things, but I wasn't expecting them till like next week or something. So, I don't know, I'm just going to open these up and see what they are. All right, let's just get this one sliced open, see what it is. I love opening prezzies. I do not know. Hang tight, guys. Huh. Oh, okay. So I know who this is from. You told me you were sending it. Thank you so, so very much. I appreciate it. And now I just need to figure out how to use this to get rid of my ants. Right on. And this one clearly says what it is on the box, so I also know who this is from. She told me she was sending it, so this is amazing soft and moist beef flavor. I'm still going to open it up anyhow. Here we go. Let's open these up. Betty is going to be excited about this one. Oh, I can't believe she sent me dog food. That is just so cool. Oh, there we go. I think we've got it now. Yay! What? Okay, that was a total fake out. This is going to be amazing. I was looking at these the other day, and I just decided, you know what? Nope, I'm not going to get it. So I'm going to put this together today and see how this works. Yay, thank you, anonymous person. I love it, I love it, I love it. And thank you also, anonymous person. I love my borax. Okay, I got a spore print of this little mushroom, and I don't know if you can see it. I can see it, but it looks like it has a brown spore print. So, let me look that up. I'm sitting in the corner where the bed used to be, and yep, everything is a total mess. Haven't even made my bed yet. Probably won't, because I'm going to go take a nap in a little bit. But the bed looks much better over there. Yep, that's a little potty area. I'm going to close this off with a curtain eventually. And I'm sitting here in my little chair, rocking back and forth. There's the girl. There's my messy kitchen. Definitely got to get that cleaned up and get the solar sorted out. So this is what it's looking like so far, you guys. I think I like it. I like this much better. because I can look out all of the windows from here, and it's very, very nice. Hey, Betty. Hey, Betty. I love you. You're a good girl. She don't care. Look, she's like, Mom, just leave me alone. So I got the spore print for that mushroom, and I was really, really, really hoping it was going to be a honey mushroom because they're kind of yellowish, and the honey mushroom shares a lot of characteristics with the mushroom that I found, but no such luck. It's not a honey mushroom at all. Actually, what it is a garland stropharia, and the way I was able to distinguish between the two of them is, well, because the gills, you know, they eventually on the garland stropharia initially turn brownish to purplish, and the spore print. That is what pretty much convinced me that no, this is not an edible honey mushroom. This is a poisonous garland stropharia. So yeah, I'm gonna go get rid of them all. But anyhow, I'm glad I have this book. It is my National Audubon Society book, Mushroom Field Guide, that I got from Francie from Finding Joy Through Serving. And dang it, I just lost my page. That's okay. It helped me to identify a mushroom that maybe I was considering eating, but I'm not going to eat it now because it's poisonous. One more thing before I go. I need to ask you guys a question who know about chickens and making chicken nesting boxes. I want to keep it very simple. I may have some things around here that I might be able to use for it. Question is, does it have to be enclosed in the back? Does it need to have something over the top? And what's the best kind of bedding to put down in it? I've heard different things from different people. So let me know what your thoughts are on the best way to build a simple nesting box that, and I'm the dimensions too. I think they need to be at least 12 by 12 by maybe 10 inches high or so. I'd like it to be lightweight as possible. I was going to use the drawers out of that old desk that's in the shed, but they're too small. They're just too small. So give me your thoughts, and so maybe I can make a couple chicken nesting boxes. Yeah. Anyway, that's all I got for you. See you in the next video. Thanks for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure you like, subscribe, hit the bell, and y'all have a good one.